Hello, Jim Howard here in Fort Worth, Texas. It's March 3rd of 2024, and it is almost 11 p.m. I'm not sure, you probably can't tell very well from the camera, but this room is a total disaster. I've moved a whole bunch of stuff around, but I mean, I've taken stuff out of the storage and put it out, and it's a mess. I'm using the Windows camera that is included with your software, with your Windows software, whatever. I'm using that. So I have a very small screen that I'm seeing, and right now there isn't any screen except the one you're seeing here. I've had a hell of a time with my software, and because of a number of things that I think I've talked about them. I've had a hell of a time. Manicam, I gave that up, and I mentioned in one of the videos, which you may not have noticed or paid any attention to. I loved Manicam software. You know, I used it for years. I had multiple licenses. When I tried to pay for the new version that just came out, when I was going to their site and trying to pay the $89 or whatever it was, my system got attacked by 9 attempts at $89 to take that out of my bank. When I logged into their site, they kept saying, you know, okay, this, you know, it's not accepting your card. And then they gave me options, you know, oh, okay, well, you know, try this or whatever. And then I got contacted by my bank. They didn't, you know, they didn't approve it. I mean, they contacted me and said, we see something suspicious here. And whatever. So luckily, I mean, I wasn't out any money, but Manicam is gone, bye-bye. Unfortunately, because I really loved it for years. I don't know how many years they were doing it, but I was, you know, like a charter member. CapCut, I have it installed on my computer. I really don't know how to use it properly. I need to learn how. I think I made a short clip or something that you'll find someplace. Right now I'm very confused about my, everything is very confusing. So I have that, and I need to learn how to properly use it. I think I made a short video clip using it. I don't know where it is. Now the other thing is, I'm going to have cataract surgery, and the first one is going to be on the 6th. Today's the 3rd, and here in a couple hours it's going to be the 4th. So I'm going to have surgery done on one eye, and then I go back, I forget how long, and then they do the second eye. You have to have a, well, that, I think last time, I think, when I got delayed because of, you know, I was scheduled to have it done, but then I could not get into my regular doctor to have, I forget what they call it, the thing that they just basically want to make sure that you're not going to have some type of reaction to local anesthetic or any other kind of anesthetic and that type of stuff. So So I was delayed a little bit. And then in the thing that I, which I think is a change that came out, said that you had to have somebody with you who was responsible. Before that it said, I believe, a relative. And then I think they changed it to somebody responsible. My amateur radio license, I paid the renew fee back 2 years ago or whatever to renew it. And then I went to the FCC website, and I'd already paid a club or whatever, amateur radio club, and it was posted, and they had filed it, you know, automatically with the FCC or whatever. But I couldn't log in. I tried 2 days to log in. I've got a friend who's in Kansas City, Missouri. We've known each other a long time. He's a Vietnam veteran. I wasn't in the Vietnam War, by the way. I didn't have bone spurs the way, what's his name? Had, but what I had was weight loss so severe that the military wouldn't take me. I thought at the time, you know, that the military would build you up, but not me. And then when I, a couple of years later, when I was called for the selective service exam where you go and they check you, there was 200 of us there. I know that because we were all naked and they used a magic marker to go 1 to 200. The doctor came over immediately, made his way through the crowd to come up to me. I was underweight, big time underweight. And he wanted to know, did you just get out of the hospital? Have you been sick or no? So then he went back and got in the line. Then he spent his rest of the time, football players or whatever, you know, bad knee or whatever, you know. And then those guys were also fainting when they were drawing blood or something or other. So, but I'm not saying that I was qualified. You know, I was underweight. I was way under the weight. Maybe we're coming full circle because I've been having to have some testing done, you know. And I've been losing weight. I'm quite a ways under 200 pounds now. So they want me to have some testing done. My doctor, well, about a year and a half ago is when I went to that doctor. Went to her and she said, you've lost a lot of weight. Have you been trying to lose weight? And I said, no. And she says, well, you know, what was the first thing when we see something like this is we're thinking cancer. So it ended up that I didn't intend to, it just got so much stuff going on and I was so busy. I didn't make a check about every 6 months they want me to. And, but this time I was about it. I think a year and 6 months or a year and 3 months or something like that. And when I went this time, the doctor said, you've lost more weight and we need to get you in for some tests. I haven't had them yet and I'm not sure I want to have those tests. But my lab work, by the way, is, I can't show it to you. I could in the past, but right now I can't show it to you, because my computer, things are not working the way they should. But my lab work is all, you know, the A1C for diabetes or whatever, the scale that they have, I'm right at the scale, top of the scale. But I mean, that's good. I'm not out of, you know, out of the scale. So that's good. I think I started to mention, or did I? There's a amateur radio operator. I think that's why I started down that. There is a amateur radio operator who lives, of course, there's, you know, Oh, anyway, I didn't get my license renewed. And I've got a friend, oh, that's how it started. I've got a friend who was in the military, and he's also been an amateur radio operator way longer than I have, and we have a lot of things in common. You know, our politics and stuff like that. And he, of course, he's not in, he's back in Kansas City. But there's an amateur radio operator, a young guy, who is really into it. I'm not in it. Well, my license has expired, so I can't be transmitting, but I really wasn't that enthusiastic about it anyway. But we went to an what do they call it? Things that the clubs, amateur radio clubs, have. I mean, they have drawings for, you know, you pay for membership to get in, or you pay a fee to get in, and then they raise money and stuff like that, and then they manufacturers or other people, you know, make available brand new equipment, and you know, you can purchase it, and you might win it at one of these ham fests. But anyway, this young man lives in this area, and he volunteered to, I have to have somebody with me, a responsible person for the operations for the day, and then you go back the next day and they check your eye. And then the second, if you're having a second one done, which I am, you know, it's, I could look it up here, I've got it written down, but it'll be a while after the first one. And so never mess with your cell phone when you're going someplace, and it's important that you have communications. I messed with my cell phone, and then when I went down, I went down for the thing, but it was for just the routine thing that they do, the very routine stuff they do at the eye place. And then, and I was using the transportation service that Fort Worth has, where you can schedule it, and you have to pay $4, and they come and pick you up, and then you pay $4, you know, coming back. But I didn't set it up, which I always do, but I didn't set it up, and I don't even remember why. I didn't set it up to be brought home, because I was going to use a Uber. And I had just upgraded. Actually, I knew, I was concerned about, you know, that I had upgraded my cell phone. And then the day before that, and then I checked to make sure everything was working okay, you know. And then in the morning, I woke up here, and it said, here are some updates, you know, and I hit update. Boom. So I get finished with the thing that didn't take very long at the, hospital. And then I went out, into the outer lobby or whatever. And boom. It had somehow changed to my previous bank information. And with my eyesight and with the way the computer was working, you know, when they do that thing where they send you a thing on your cell phone, and when they do other stuff, you know, a message pops up, you know, six numbers or seven numbers or something like that. And with my cell phone that I was using and am still using. You know, let's say six numbers pop up. With the Samson, nope. Was it the Samson? That's the one I'm still using. Where is it? Oh man, this room is a fucking mess. I don't know where it is. Anyway, I couldn't put in the correct bank code. And it messed up some other thing. Well, what it was messing up was the thing pops up. You know, they send you the code, and then the Samson, when the thing pops up, the Samson right away has something pop up on top of it, you know? And so, anyway, that's been fixed. But anyway, the amateur radio operator that's a young guy, and he is in this area, and he saw my thing about it, and he contacted me and said, "Hey Jim, I'll take you." And so that doesn't come up again. Something like that doesn't come up again. That'd be especially bad if you just had an operation on your eye and they want you to go home and take it easy for, you know, a day and stuff like that. But come in the next day to have it checked also. And somebody has to come with you on that day also. Now, the other days that they have for things, nobody needs to go with you. But anyway, so this young man is going to... I didn't realize that he was actually, that he lived so close here. So anyway, he volunteered, you know, he'll take me for these, but what I'm just doing is just the ones where I have to have somebody with me. You know, he's got a life to live, you know. And although I'm sure he would do it, but I'm not gonna, you know, I'm just asking him to do it for 4 days, you know, two for the first surgery and two for the second surgery. So anyway, he's really interested in being an amateur radio operator, and way more interested. I'm not interested at all, but as my license expired, and I'm trying to get it reinstated. I would just like to have it. So they have a thing, you know, in the magazines or whatever, in the QST, the amateur radio magazine, and that type of stuff. And when somebody dies, it's an amateur radio operator. They're listed, you know, their call sign, where they were registered, where they live, you know, whatever. And I mean, not their address, you know, but. They're listed as silent keys, you know, because of Morse code. Whatever, you know. And I'd like to be listed as a silent key. I think that sounds pretty neat. I mean, it would be better to be listed as a Medal of Honor winner or, you know, a wealthy man or something, but I'll just have to settle for silent key. So I'm trying to get my license reinstated. Man, the Federal Communications Commission. And I thought it was me. I thought it was me. There's the friend I think I just mentioned earlier. Not the guy that lives here, but the one, I think I mentioned him. We've been friends for a long time. Anyway, the young man who is going to be taking me to the hospital and bringing me back. I think he's got a couple radios, I think. But I, since I don't have a license, I loaned him my dual band radio, and we went to a ham event the other day, where they do drawings and people bring their stuff and spread it out and, you know, sell stuff, that kind of stuff. And so I loaned him my ham radio. And when he was there, he went and bought, he liked it so much, you know. I told him he could use it, you know, because I can't transmit on right now. But he went ahead and after a couple of days of just using it, when he was there, he bought one, the very same one. And so that's a good sign that he got to try it out. And he liked, he said he liked the feel of it and everything right away. Now I think that the sound quality with this, because I listened to a little bit of it, 15 seconds or something, and this has been going for 21 minutes. I think the sound quality is bad, but I think maybe audio gives me more of a problem with things. So I hope you can take this right now. I'll be working on fixing that. Man, I do not have, well, I might have, I don't think I have carpal tunnel, but man, this hurts right in, because why would I have carpal tunnel after all these years? And but then it developed over in this hand, which I don't use this hand, you know. I don't use a mouse with this hand or anything. So I think I'm going to make this a 30. Oh, by the way, if you look on the my website or my YouTube site, you'll find a link, I think a couple, that take you to TikTok. And my daughter, my oldest daughter, she has, and there's a link to it someplace on my YouTube site. She has a very successful new TikTok site. And she's doing great because she's smart. I can say that because I'm not smart. But, and you know how hard it is for me to make a short video. But I'm going to, I think I've already put the title in or whatever, so it's there someplace, but I don't think I'm directing anybody there. But I'm going to try to make some TikTok videos. But I wish I could get a new computer, because I'm having trouble. So I'd like to get a new computer, but I don't think I can afford it. So I'll be making it with making this TikTok stuff that may not be as good as I could do. I've got a birthday coming up in March. This is March. I have a birthday coming up. Maybe I have been a good boy, and maybe somebody will get me a new computer. Oh, by the way, I have this problem, which people say is carpal tunnel, but I'm also having it over here. I don't think it is carpal tunnel. Also, this shoulder here is coming out of the joint, and it really hurts when I have to pick something up with it, and I have to pick up 24 packs of Coke, you know, and that hurts. All of a sudden I'm old. Yeah, I've talked about that before, that, you know, just a few years ago. Well, I guess that's for, well, more than that, because it'd be about over 10 years, because the first pacemaker was in me for 10 years. And then I have one that I think's been in me for maybe 4 years or something. but before that, fairly recently, I'm 82 right now. I'll be 83 this month. But I would go to doctors, you know, and they would want my medical, you know. Okay, how many operations have you had? None. You haven't had any, you know, you haven't had any operations? No. And it's like, so then a couple of times I said, I think that was back when they were putting pacemakers in me. They still are putting a pacemaker in me. And I said, well, I had my tonsils out. No, that doesn't count. I said, well, I haven't had anything, you know, no operations or anything. So, it's really interesting. My daughter, LaDonna, who has a TikTok site, I think I have 4,000 subscribers on my YouTube site. And I started in 2005, and I have 4,000. I finally reached 4,000 subscribers. I mean, I have more viewers than that, but these are people that actually clicked on the button, you know, to be a subscriber. Doesn't cost them anybody to pay it. You know, there's no charge for it, you know. But I forget how many thousands of subscribers she has, and I think a year or two, I think it's less than 2 years she's been doing it. And she just does, she's smart, and she just does things the right, you know, the right way. I could do better if my computer was better and if my software. I miss Manicam, but wow. I know what it feels like. Do you know what it feels like to wake? Actually, the bank, I think, contacted me and said, you know, will you check in and see if there's a suspicious thing, you know, on your thing. And I went there and there was nine, or I think it was 18, and it, I forget now. Okay, it's almost 30 minutes. I hope this audio sounds okay. It's really sad. I can, this isn't a great video, but I've made some pretty good video. And sound seems to be my problem. But it's not my fault. Anyway, well, you can still subscribe. Yeah, I don't need to stop at 4,000. Or was it 5,000? I think it was 4,000. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Give a thumbs up, leave a comment, whatever you can do. Thank you very much.